बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। टुडेज आवर लेक्चर इज़ अबाउट द डाइसेक्राइड्स। योर कोर्स इज़ बायोकेमिस्ट्री ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स। वी हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर द मोनोसेक्राइड्स इन विच द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मोनोसेक्राइड इज़ द ग्लूकोज, विच इज़ इन्वॉल्व फॉर द हाई एनर्जी प्रोडक्शन of the body. It is very important monosaccharide. Now we are going towards the disaccharides. Disaccharides actually the carbohydrates which on complete hydrolysis yields two sugar molecules or the two monosaccharides, monomeric units. These are different maltose, lactose, sucrose, triallose, cellulose, cellulose. These are the different types of disaccharides: maltose, lactose, sucrose, trehalose and cellulose. They are in which the two monosaccharide units are attached with each other by the glycosidic linkage, in glycosidic linkage, glycosidic bonds. Maltose is the monosaccharide unit of alpha D glucose plus alpha D glucose. So two glucose units are alpha D glucose units are attached with each other for the formation of the maltose. In case of lactose, one alpha D glucose with one beta D glucose. One alpha D glucose is attached with one beta D glucose. In case of sucrose, alpha D glucose is combined with the beta D fructose. In case of triallose, alpha D glucose plus alpha D glucose both are attached with each other. And in case of cellulose, beta D glucose plus beta D glucose are attached with each other. Beta D glucose. Disaccharides are of different types. First one is the maltose, in which two alpha D glucose molecules are attached with each other. In case of lactose, one alpha D glucose and one beta D glucose are attached with each other for the formation of the lactose. In case of sucrose, one alpha D glucose and one beta D fructose molecule is attached with each other. In case of triallose, one alpha D glucose and two alpha D glucose molecules are attached with each other for the formation of the triallose. In case of cellulose, two beta D glucose molecules are attached with each other. Now we are discussing about all of them one by one. First of all, we are we are studied about the maltose. Structure of maltose. This is the structure of the maltose in which two glucose molecules are attached with each other with the alpha 1 4 linkage. The first carbon of the one glucose molecule is attached with the fourth carbon of the other molecule. So the anomeric carbon of the second glucose molecule, anomeric carbon of second glucose molecule is free. So this one is called as a reducing sugar. Disaccharides are of two types: reducing sugars, reducing or non-reducing disaccharides. So this is the type of the reducing sugar because the one anomeric carbon is involved in the linkage alpha 1 4 glycosidic linkage, and the second glucose molecule's anomeric carbon is free, which can be reacted with the other molecules for different reactions. So this is the reducing sugar. It is a reducing sugar. Maltose is usually present in the plants, and during the hydrolysis of the starch, the maltose is obtained by the during the malting process when the starch is hydrolyzed, then the maltose is formed during the hydrolysis of the starch molecules. So its more prevalence is in the plant. Their source is the germinating cereals and malts. Germinating cereals, they are mostly present in germinating cereals and malt formation and malting process, in which the starch is hydrolyzed. During the chemical reactions, it forms the ozazones with the phenyl hydrazine. It is permeable by the enzyme maltase present in the yeast. Maltase enzyme is present in the yeast, so it is permeable by the maltase enzyme present in the yeast. It hydrolyzed for the giving the 2D glucose molecules, which undergo mutarotation. So it is mutarotated. Also the mutarotated. Next one is the Lactose. Lactose. First of all, we know about the general structure of the lactose. This is the general structure of the lactose. In which beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage is present. In case of lactose, the beta 1,4 linkage is present. The beta glucose The beta D glucose is involved in this case, beta 1,4 linkage, in which the one alpha carbon and one beta carbon. The beta D glucose plus alpha D glucose. This one is the alpha D glucose and this one is the beta D glucose, and the linkage is beta 1,4. The beta position of 1 glucose molecule is attached with the alpha fourth position of the other glucose molecule, and in which these two glucose molecules are attached by the beta 1,4 linkage and form the lactose. Because in it one anomeric carbon is involved in the bonding of this beta 1,4 linkage, and the second anomeric carbon is also free in this, which can give the reaction. So this is also, lactose is also called as the reducing sugar. It is called as the milk sugar. It is mostly present in the milk and high in the mammary glands. Amounts is, it can be seen, It shows reactions that of the reducing sugars, including the mutation, decomposes by the alkali and non-fermentable by the yeast, hydrolyzed to one molecule of lactose, one molecule of glucose by acids and the enzyme lactase. Beta 1,4 leakage, in which one galactose and glucose. This is the monomer of glucose plus galactose. Monomer of beta glucose with the beta galactose. Lactase enzyme is present, which can break down this beta 1,4 linkage, and the glucose and the galactose are freed from each other by the breakage of this beta 1,4 linkage. And in case of the lactose intolerance, the lactase enzyme is not present in that person, which leads to the lactose intolerance, and lactose is not digested by dead infants. Next one is next one is the cellobios. The structure of cellobios cellobios in which two beta D glucose, two beta D glucose molecules are attached with each other by beta 1,4 linkage. In which two beta D glucose molecules are attached with each other by the beta D beta 1,4 linkage, and this cellobios is the product, hydrolytic product of the hydrolysis of cellulose. During the hydrolysis of cellulose, cellobios is produced, and this cellobios is very important for the plants because the cellulose is very important for plants. Then the next one is the trehalose. Trehalose, in which two glucose molecules are attached with each other by the alpha 1,1 linkage. In which alpha 1,1 linkages present, and two glucose molecules are attached in case of trehalose. Two glucose molecules are attached with each other by the alpha 1-1 linkage. So both the alpha 1 molecule, alpha 1 carbons are involved for the linkage of, for the formation of trehalose. Trehalose is a non-reducing sugar because the both the anomeric carbons are involved in the linkage. So this one is a non-reducing sugar in which both the anomeric carbons are involved for the formation of bonds. So this is a non-reducing sugar. Trehalose is very important for the plants because it occurs a major constituent of the circulatory fluid of insects. It is present in majorly in the insects, and it is the major constituent of the circulatory fluid of the carbohydrates are circulated in case of insects in the form of trehalose. Its amount of energy is double to the glucose. It gives the twice more amount of energy as it is produced by the glucose. So this is very important for the insects and the plants. Next one is the sucrose is a very important disaccharide because it is also called as the sucrose is very important disaccharide because it is also called as the table sugar. So very important sugar which is we use in our daily life, which is get from the sugar beet or sugar cane, is the sucrose. Sucrose contains a high amount of energy which is used by the persons for the production of the energy. So let's see the structure of the sucrose. Sucrose is the disaccharide of glucose plus fructose. In which alpha D glucose is combined with the beta fructose, and the linkage is the alpha 1 2 glycosidic linkage, because in it also the two anomeric carbons are involved in the formation of the linkage. So there is no free anomeric carbon for the reaction. So sucrose is also the
non-reducing sugar. Non-reducing sugar. This is also called as the non-reducing sugar. It is a very important sugar. It can be get from the sugar cane and the sugar beet. Sole sources of the this sucrose. Sucrose is a sugar of commercial importance. It's widely distributed in the higher plants. It is made up of glucose and fructose. The anomeric carbon atoms of glucose C1 and the fructose C2 are involved in linkages, and therefore this is a non-reducing sugar, non-reducing disaccharide. Sucrose is a major intermediate product of photosynthesis. It is very important product of the photosynthesis, and it is the principal form in which the sugar is transported from the leaves to the other portions of the plants via the vasculatory systems. It is also called as the invert sugar because it inverts the optical rotation, changes from the positive dextrorotatory to levorotatory. It can change the position of the optical rotation from the positive to the negative, the dextrorotatory to levorotatory. So that's why it is called as the invert sugar, mixture of the invert sugar. The liver rotation is due to the presence of the fructose, which is itself more liver rotatory than the dextrorotatory. This phenomena is called as the inversion, and the mixture of the glucose and fructose is called as the invert sugar. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme invertase, which converts this the positive sugar into the dextrorotatory form into the liver rotatory form. Invert sugar, the disaccharide sucrose is more sweeter than the sucrose. Honey contains the plenty of the invert sugar, and therefore it is very sweet. It is more sweet as compared to the sucrose. Sucrose is fermentable, hydrolyzed by the dilute acids or enzymes, sucrase, to one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose. Relatively stable to reactions with the dilute alkalis. Sucrose is also called as the table sugar, so it is used as for the production of the energy, but it can also be converted into invert sugar because it is optically active. Sucrose is optically active, so when the optical rotation is occurred, then this glucose is more dextrorotatory and fructose is more levorotatory. So the fructose, because fructose is more levorotatory as compared to the dextrorotatory, so that's why it changes its position, its optical activity from the dextrorotatory to levorotatory. It forms the invert sugar. This invert sugar is more sweeter than the sucrose, and its large amount is present in the honey. So that's why the honey is more sweeter as compared to the general table sugar, which is used for the enrichment of the sucrose. Also, sucrose is used for the formation of fructose. Used for the formation of the different artificial sweeteners. So the artificial sweeteners give the less amount of energy because they not contain the glucose, so they only contain the fructose, and these artificial sweeteners give the more sweetness to the to taste, and they are different from the general table sugar because it not contains the glucose and they give the less amount of energy. The diabetic patients are use the artificial sweeteners which are formed from the fructose. That is all about the disaccharides. Disaccharides are also very important for the different reactions, for the different processes, for example, sucrose is very important in case of the photosynthesis. Sucrose is very important as the table sugar.
lactose is very important for the infants because it is the milk sugar, and the maltose is very important during the malting process. Cellulose is very important for the hydrolysis of the cellulose, and the trehalose is very important for the insects and for the plants for the production of the energy. So these all the disaccharides have their own importance in the different types of plants, and they are also very important for the animals and the humans. That's all about the disaccharides. Thank you so very much, students. If you have any questions regarding this lecture, you can approach me on the WhatsApp group, either you can approach me on my email address or by putting the comments in the comment section. Thank you so very much. Allah Hafiz.